Performing calculations. In ABAP, you can program arithmetic expressions nested to any debt. Valid operations include the addition, the subtraction, multiplication, the division, exponentiation, the div or the integral division without remainder, and the mod, that is the remainder after the integral division. You also have the keyword strlen. That statement provides the current length of a content of a character variable or a string, and you can store that length in a variable. In this case, it's also called length, and that variable has to be of type I, of type integer. Let's look in the system and let's practice some arithmetic expressions, and let's try using the string length ABAP keyword. Let's practice some calculations inside our subsystem. As always, let's navigate to the object navigator. We're going to practice the add, subtract, multiply, divide, the div, the mod, and the strlength keywords. All of these are keywords inside the ABAP programming language. So let's create another program. Let's work inside the same package. And let's create a program called zCalculations. We leave the title as it is. We want it to be an executable program, and we save. Now, let's start by declaring some variables, because we're going to declare more than one variable. I use 2 points. So let's declare a variable type integer so we can perform arithmetic calculations. Another variable type integer also. And a third variable where we're going to store all of our results. So for example, if you want to add 2 numbers or 3 numbers in ABAP, it is really easy. You can just use the normal way of adding numbers. And you know, you write it to the screen. You write the result. You can also add numbers using the add keyword in ABAP. So you can type add LB1 to LB2. And we can also write that to the screen. Result of addition. Sorry. And this is also the result of addition. We're just gonna write it. No, let's leave it like that. Result. Let's try the subtract number. So let's subtract 2 numbers now. So you can use the keyword subtract, and we subtract from, this time we use the keyword from LB1. Sorry, this is LB2. And let's write the result to the screen. So now we perform an addition and we write the result. Then we add, we do the same thing, and when then we display the result, then we subtract and we display the result. Now, as you can see, I have a mistake here. I haven't assigned values yet to LV1 and LV2. We have two options. We can either ask for input values to the user, or we can assign the values ourselves. In this case, we're going to assign the values directly. So let's assign 5 and 10. I'm still missing one thing. I have to use the clear ABAP statement to clear my variables after each operation. This will prevent any mistakes from happening. So for example, I add two numbers and I write the result. After that, I clear all of my variables, including the first two variables. That will clear all my variables, and then I assign them one more time and I add again. Let's add 2 and 4 this time, and then I'm gonna clear one more time, then I'm gonna assign again, subtract 4 from 2. Let's make it the other way around, but let's make it 20 and 10. So I use 20 and 10. Now I subtract 10 from 20 and I write the result of subtraction. And I have a mistake here also. I have to write variable 1. Why? Because I'm gonna subtract 10 from 20 and that will store my result in variable 1. So I print out LB1. So now we're expecting a 15, a 6, and a 10. Let's check, activate, and run. A 15, a 6, and a 10. Let's try with the multiplication. Remember to clear, so I'm gonna copy this. Now let's multiply 30 times 10. So we use the multiply. Multiply LB1 by LB2. Then we write it also. So we just copy, paste. Result of multiplication. Should give us 300. And let's try that division. So let's just copy the whole segment. Let's change this for divide. And let's leave it like that. So our answer should be 3. We divide 30 by 10. This should give us 3, and this should give us 300. So we save, we check, we activate, and we run our program. As you can see, we have 303. Let's try making a small program where you ask two values to the user, and then you ask if you want to add, multiply, subtract, or divide those numbers, and then you print to the screen the result. A small calculator with just four basic arithmetic operations.